audience, but the audience isn't like, oh, everything's solved.
It's know your audience, but there's also the question of, you know, when he gives a good speech, and we'll watch this again State of the Union night Tuesday, if he gives a good speech off teleprompter, can he stick with it? In the sense that one big goal in Davos was to get the U.S.-Britain relationship back on track. He sat down with the U.K. Prime Minister Theresa May. There's been a lot of tension about Trump's retweets of a hateful British anti-Muslim group, some other tensions in the relationship. They have a meeting, although the Prime Minister was very muted, but they have a meeting to try to get things back on track. But listen to the President here in an interview with our old CNN friend Piers Morgan, where he says, well, you know, I like Theresa May, but she really did a lousy job negotiating her exit from the European Union.
Well, would it be the way I negotiate? No, I wouldn't negotiate it the way it's negotiated, but I have a lot of respect for your prime minister, and I think they're doing a job. I think I would have negotiated it differently. I would have had a different attitude.
What would you have done?
I think I would have said that the European Union is not cracked up to what it's supposed to be, and I would have taken a tougher stand in getting out.
So he insults Theresa May and the entire European Union. Is that so much for the olive branch, or do the leaders, the bigger question, we laugh about these things, but the bigger question is, do the leaders say, that's the President of the United States, not the guy reading a teleprompter?
I think it goes to what Jeff's saying. You know, you have the teleprompter, he went to the Davos, he gave the speech that everyone wanted to hear, it provided some hope, and then some reality kind of swept in. I think the idea that obviously you need to be very careful about putting too much weight on any certain tweet, conversation, speech, and this is a perfect example, as well as the comments about Hillary and the fake news.
But to your point, he has spectacular talent for stepping on his own message right after accolades. He'll say something that completely either flips it on its head or taints it a little bit. And we've saw that, as you said, with the not State of the Union, whatever we were calling it last year. And I'm sure his advisors going into this State of the Union are imparting this to him. Don't step on your own message.
And interestingly, he had just finished meeting with the prime minister just moments before doing this interview. And he said, any discussion of us having a bad relationship is is false. The reality here is this U.S. president still has not visited there. There are tensions there. So this interview with Piers Morgan was, I think, more of a window into who the president really is.
We'll see. They said they were going to work on getting that visit back on track. We'll see if that interview helps or hurts. Have a good